Hey, it's Greg from Scholar Farms, and I'm down here in San Diego at SlantRange. I'm here with Matt. Matt, thanks for having me.
Of course, always good to have you.
We are here to talk about the newest sensor from SlantRange for mapping vegetation, my favorite topic to talk about, and that's the 4P and 4P Plus. So yep. Matt, tell us a little bit about what's the difference, what's the newest upgrades on the 4P Plus. That's here on the M200 series. You also have it here in this nice little hard case as well.
Sure. Yeah, I mean, kind of keeping our commitment, I guess, to our three kind of primary drivers in the space. But number one is data accuracy. Mm-hmm. So we've still got our ambient illumination sensor here. We've got an overhauled navigation system, including RTK.
Okay.
So accuracy across the board.
And that accuracy is on the data as well. We're not just talking about RTK for navigation. We're talking about RTK pin on the imagery.
Exactly. So geolocation accuracy of the imagery, which of course flows through to the maps. We've also added this new hardware component. You can see it better here, I suppose. That's a laser rangefinder. So in addition to very high resolution and high accurate position measurements, we now have a very accurate altitude measurement. So
okay.
Sending a laser pulse to the ground and getting accurate altitude.
So that's important if you really want to understand maybe plant size metrics.
Exactly.
and you're trying to do high resolution time series data. The laser will tell you exactly the distance off the ground.
That's right.
Where the photo was taken.
Yeah, so plant size, also plant counting. Basically anytime you want to look at some specific measurements of a plant, you need to know how high you are off the ground, which tells you the area that you're looking at, and that flows through to size.
So when we're looking at our narrowband imagery, so tell me again about the bands that we're shooting. So every time it triggers, what are we getting?
Sure, yeah, so we've gone from 4 bands to 6 bands,
okay.
Four apertures here, but we've got an RGB camera now, so integrated RGB, so you have that for context, and then 3 narrowbands.
Okay, so every time I fly, I'm usually flying like my Phantom and then another sensor as
exactly.
Well. I always want RGB because it's intuitive to look at. It's the first thing I want to look at.
Right.
And then we get our narrowband imagery for our plant indices.
Right. Right. So we've got close to twice the resolution of our prior generation sensors. So those are now 2.2 centimeters at 100 meters. So
okay.
Very high resolution.
Yeah, yep. You can get leaf level measurements
exactly.
That way. So
yeah.
It's not just general field health now we can start getting some sort of phenotypes with our plants.
Exactly, yeah. This really was designed around our, what we call aerial phenotyping, so the really high resolution, high specificity data for kind of research and breeding customers, particularly in small plot work, so that's really what this is targeted for.
Yeah, so higher end folks that are really interested in the data side and they want to do it both through time or even within a plot and taking different metrics.
Right.
Also, we have still have the PSDK from
the
DJI.
Skyport.
Yep. So the Skyport, we can have plug it right into the M200 series and the M200, M210, and control it directly through our apps and see the data from the sensor coming in
exactly.
To the app.
And power, of course, straight through the port. So no power cables, no battery.
On Slantview, there's a total refresh as well as of the software. Tell me a little bit about what you guys updated.
Yeah, sure. So we've done just a total overhaul on Slantview. We call it Slantview 3.0. You can see it here on the screen. But yeah, kind of really overhauling the user interface, data management. We got some new tools for visualization. Maybe we can show you some screenshots of those. But kind of overlaying the imagery with the maps and getting that real-time view. Queuing up data processing, so you can start to do batch processing, command line processing. So lots of new features all built into them.
Yeah, that's kind of in line with the industry as well. Is okay, now you have individual teams going out, but now you need to really think about how you scale your program. And
yep.
You really got to build the back-end side of the data as well. It's really important to think about, particularly for large agricultural operations.
Yeah.
So lots to talk about. We could talk all day about both the analytics and the hardware side of things. But that's enough, I think, to get people started. They can go to
sure.
The SlantRange website and learn more.
Absolutely, and at SlantRange.com, support at SlantRange, sales at SlantRange. Yeah.
All right. We're here in San Diego. We're going to go to the beach later and not do plant mapping, mostly just hang out at the beach. But I'm Greg with Scholar Farms. I hope that's interesting to you. You can check us out at scholarfarms.com. Again, that's a 4P and 4P+. We'll talk to you again soon.